make it rain. Oh, Cody, hear the thunder. No, don't let it bring you back. Look up and see the light. You're not alone, don't give up like that. Oh, yeah, got a ways to go. Break that wall, let the spirit flow.
I know you ain't there yet. Don't stop to catch your breath. You're going higher and higher, higher and higher. Let go, set me free. Got the streets all I need. You're going higher.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Anticipation is bouncing for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Bortles' Jaguars going up against Ryan's Falcons.
All right, we appreciate it, Larry. It's our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Jacksonville Jaguars. Josh Lambeau now ready to put this one in the air. And we are underway from Atlanta. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Now Ryan on first down and finding the tight end Hooper. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. 5 yards left for the offense. It's second down. Gabriel, the man in motion. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he'll be knocked down sideways. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight. They run the play fake to Coleman. Now Ryan. Finding Gabriel complete. And he's brought down, but not before getting across midfield to the 45. A really good pickup of 28 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. This is Freeman on first and 10. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
They don't want it, fellas. They don't want it. Keep playing hard, fellas. All day.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Escaping the pressure right. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Flushed out right. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And now before this fourth and two play comes to fruition, they're going to think about it and call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Paul Posluszny. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception throw.
And that last one, that hurts. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And they didn't wait long to take a shot there, that's for sure. But it falls incomplete, and it's second down. Marquise Lee, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Working from the gun, it's Bortles. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. A very solid gain of 27.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to grade the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. But the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit him over the top.
And complete to Lewis over the middle. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A very solid gain of 27. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first. Quarter, they're down to one remaining. Fournette, a first down carry, looking for a crease, can't find one, stopped at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up third down.
I know in every game we do, we talk about momentum. That was a momentum play lost. And now, there could be a letdown because they didn't get the interception.
Yeah, you could almost hear the collective gasp on the sideline. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford. He's got daylight. He's at the 40, the 20, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Falcons.
Well, someone just made a house call, and his name is Robert Alford. You remember that name, don't you, partner?
Seen him on the biggest of stages, picking off Tom Brady in Super Bowl 51.
Yeah, took it all the way back for a touchdown, then gave his team a 21-3 lead. They didn't hold it, but that was a mammoth play.
That was a mammoth play, and what we just saw was a mammoth play. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. As possession changes hands here, I get to talk to you about the Super Bowl. It's New England and Philly, a repeat of Super Bowl 39, although that one was in Jacksonville. This one, of course, in Minneapolis.
Yeah, I think the only thing that really changes is the weather. But this one's in a dome, so I don't think that that's a real issue for them at all. But guess what? New England has the same coach and the same quarterback. That's a big advantage for the Patriots.
Meanwhile, for Philly, everything's new, including the quarterback and Nick Foles that they didn't think would be there right now.
And I'm not sure Nick Foles thought he would be there at that point. But remember, he's been to the Pro Bowl before, been to the playoffs as a starter in the NFL. He's got a chance to play a really big game.
8 yards to go here on second down. Shotgun now for Bortles. Dumps it off to Fournette. And oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. Bortles on the give to Fournette. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it at every position, and we just saw there some linebackers that can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. Alongside the former defensive back, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Jaguar football as we begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out. The gun, it's Bortles, eluding the pressure right, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. He was looking to get it to Allen Hurns that time, and it's third down.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Nortman on to kick as he sends it away. This is taken at the 23. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Falcons. Tevin Coleman, 77 yards. And the Falcons are able to show off their quick strike ability. And his kick is good. So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
Punt's better. Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn it into first downs and hopefully points.
He's going to go for it. He rifles one that's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. Falcons taking over on offense in just a second, and, you know, this year ended in disappointing fashion now. Last year was the ultimate version of heartbreak, but if you're a Falcon fan, was this one was tough to swallow as well, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because let's be honest about it. Losing in the Super Bowl, I don't care how you lose, you're in the Super Bowl. You're playing for it all. This team was supposed to be as good or better. Ultimately ended up 10-6, found their way in the playoffs, but didn't get the deep run as they had the year before. So you're exactly right. For Falcons fans, that's a tough one. But this is a team that's built to be good for a long time.
And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. And with that, they're now out of timeouts. And still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. They toss to Freeman. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really shred your defense.
Freeman a first down and more. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae Freeman, 41 yards. And the Falcons will extend. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And some dangerous territory. You're already down 3 scores. A 3-and-out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Another dangerous throw there, partner. I mean, he's already thrown 2 interceptions here in the first half. I don't know if you want to keep throwing up 50-50 balls and you've had that kind of lack of success.
Yeah, absolutely. Very well could have been a 3rd interception in half number one. Offense looking to avoid a 3rd and long. It's 2nd and 10. Quarles going to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Lewis. And he's brought down after a good game. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
They had 2 tight ends in the formation on that one. It looked to me like he had his pick of receivers downfield.
I think he was just planning on going over the middle. That's what he did.
Picked up first down, too.
And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford. Fights through and now a crease. Through an opening and there he goes. And he takes this one back into the end zone and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. That pick 6 extending this lead even further. And boy, it's been a while since I've seen a team struggle this badly in the first half.
I think all they want to do is get to the locker room, try and regroup, and come out to start the 3rd quarter but things don't improve fast then, I think the backups get a lot of play in the second half.
Here's Bryant for the extra point. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Out comes the Jaguar offense now as they get set to take over. Typically down in the first half, I might say, oh, you at least need a field goal out of this drive, but they're down to the point where they need a touchdown, don't they?
Yeah, normally you know me. I mean, you've been around me for a while now, right?
Unfortunately.
I'm sorry about that. But normally I'm the one preaching patience.
Yeah.
You know, take your time, first half, you still got a chance. I think they're out of patience here. This has to be a drive that gets a touchdown. So if you're the play caller, you're going to that portion of the sheet that says big-time plays, specials, anything you can use to get yourself back into it.
Flush to his right. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there, a 22. They'll run it now out of the gun. And 3 yards there takes him to the 45.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Escaping the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Flushed out right. He can run for it, and he will. 16 yards that time on the pickup for the Jags and a first down.
On third down, he obviously wants to throw the football, but there's nowhere to go with it, so he takes off and goes. And now as he gets to the first down marker, he blows right past it and picks up big yardage. Partner, that's a great bit of improvisation.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Steps away to his left, and he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. So a minute 56 to play in this first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. They go play action for Yeldon. Now it's Bortles. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Adrian Claiborne with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of 7. Bortles to throw for it on fourth down. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Well, Charles, he's thrown 5 picks in a game before. And right now, after that one, he's standing on number 4.
And right now, your defensive coordinator is asking the offense coordinator, can you do anything to slow this down? Because my guys have to keep running back out on the field. So play calling may come into it a little bit, maybe run the ball a little bit more. But a lot of it depends on the scoreboard. They may have to keep throwing it.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Freeman again. Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Falcons add on. Bryant now to tack on the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Here's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Here comes the Jaguars' offense as they get set here. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Hey, don't forget, by the way, as I go off on a tangent here for a second, that we got the Pro Bowl coming up in Orlando on January 28th, so that'll be something.
I do like the fact that they play at the weekend.
And he is going to be hit and taken down. Bortles sacked. Adrian Claiborne in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight. Following the sack, third and long for Bortles and the Jags. Throwing now is Bortles. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Now a play fake here on first down. Airing it out for Hearns. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Out come the Jaguars now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
You're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the ute. Man, know that I kick up the ute. Them boy there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? No, you're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the ute. Man, know that I kick up the ute. Them boy there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? Wanna come round here like a bad boy, do it. Run all the talking, go on and do it. Running through the party, bottle of those on my ear saying storms, don't do it. Devil on my shoulder, I don't lack. Hit him with a business, I don't scrap. Even when I'm barred, I'm so easy ride, but there's no car and no match.
What are you talking about?
Clown, stand down. Never had a thing, never had a pound. You were never bad then, you ain't bad now. Never had them, had a then. Look back down. Wait, I saw bare kicks, saw bare clothes. Said not that, I can't wear those. I don't like them, they're not my thing. They went silent, they're all weirdos. Like, yeah, storms gone clear. Never had a Tom Ford or a Montclair. Man, them a car, but you see my don there. Tell them don't do it, don't dare. Don't care who you know from my block. You're not Al Capone, Al Capone. They can take my car and my creps. I still do the road in my socks. Like, who's gonna stop me? You, him, little man. I got blue slims. Don't be an idiot. Move smart. I've been killing it. New king. You were never ready for my new stuff. You're a boy by yourself. Go and group up. And when crep went states for the BTs, I was covering crep like a boot cut. If mad, it's a family thing. Straight family thing. Dumb man, I broke no salary thing. Had a young team called Amy telling me to come round hers on a Valerie thing. Hashtag Murky Academy thing. You were like art and the gallery thing. Dumb boy there wanna chat about bars, wanna chat about but. You're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the ute. Man, know that I kick up the ute. Them boy there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? Look, I'm too hot. I got money in my shoebox.
I'm the man of the house when my show sold out like the brother from the Boondocks. Beat Swan on my boombox. Still meat from the stew pot. Man, I'm go sick with my tune drops. Little man, that's a who blow, not a who blow. What? Pronounce it right. I go Maggie, I'm down to die for this. I don't care, bro, I'm down. Mad stress, so I'm bound to lie. But it's wait. I'm down to ride for flips. Real G's gonna ride around to this. Man, I got no time to write a diss. I never left my 9 to 5 for this waste, man, ting. I don't care what rave man's in. I came here to relax, but if it gets mad, make a young boy take man's things. Try to tell me I'm way too big to rebel. Nah, man, you're never too big to rebel. I was in the O2 singing my lungs out, rude, but you're never too big for Adele. Leave my yard, blow a kiss to my girl. Salute to my sister as well. Gotta keep trophies down at my mum's bit. Man, I'm getting way too big for my shelf. Man, I see bare MCs on the sideline, but I still got a couple bangs in the pipeline. Man, I got grown men at me. You're getting way too old for the timeline. You're getting way too old for this. Should've looked after your kids. Get out the booth, go home to your son. It's never too late to commit. It's like, man, love, put my name in a random flag, get a plane to Qatar. This year I learned how to take care of business. Next year I learned how to play the guitar. You're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the U. Man, know that I kick up the U. Them way there try to twist up the truth. How dare you twist up the truth? Look, you're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the U. Man, know that I kick up the U. Them boy dare try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth?
Too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody all the main. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run. I was born for this.
Whip.
On to the visual, I wanna be invisible. Looking at my ears like I'm out of dumb. Everybody needs to be a part of them. Never be enough from the prodigal son. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down.
Hypothetical, working out of something that I'm proud of. Out of the box, an epoxy to the world and the vision we've lost. I'm an apostrophe to remind you that there's more to see. I'm just a product of the system of catastrophe, and yet a masterpiece, and yet I'm half deceased. And when I am deceased, at least I go down to the grave and die happily. Leave the body of my soul to be a part of it. Do what it takes.
Whatever it takes.
takes.
Legging with Nick, we dump it off like V. Ramanovic. Sorry, homie, you know we not friends, it's off of politics. Politics never get to see who really running. Now you know who running. You rappers on punishment. Papa dog, they be lying on their brother. Everybody scared a little Linky, man, is evident. Feeling like 50 way back in 03 or D. Talking about me on some other 301 screaming 4-4 on my Louis. Papa tags by the mode, don't they tell me? Three my for a gold. Black and yellow with the boots and the ghost suit. We had a go-go last week. We don't really care who got last week. Riding under me, the blog and really bumping me. Go some bad. You don't want no problems with a GD, CPG. I'm the king of the streets. I never had to struggle when it threw a beef. Always 10 toes, so it's hard to defeat. And trust me, I've been looking hard for a beef, huh? He ain't rapped this hard in a long time. You street, all Vita dudes and nines. Homie, always say we to the guys. All my life, been addicted to the power, ain't gon' lie, yo. Ain't no fear, I'm never willing, put the shit up in yo. Ain't no telling when we do it, we just didn't get ya. Got a bad thing, it ain't lie, lie. Why, with some keep my mind wide, north side, bumpin' north, north with a deck. When I was a baby, I was wildin' for respect. You gon' get your with the set. Fuck around here and talk crazy, you get up. We ran so many out of here. Wonder why young Linky never had a fear. Say it once, say it twice, you gon' get peace. Anybody ever ask what happened with the bleach? Running from they almost had me wanna slip. Way, way back, I almost started dip. Run the same time, bumping to y'all versus dip. I ain't know who went harder, made me wanna celebrate. Now we in the game and I'm so busy from the bank. Look at you like the dog, look where you came. I don't give a fuck about man, yeah, change. And let your style, and I need my change. DMV, I'm a year. Legging, 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 legging with my fears. Rapping, but I'm quiet when I'm near. Always plotting on the bitches and I'm plotting on my fears. We don't need no checks from the boys. We just need respect from the boys. We don't want to fall in love by the force. So I just get the little reeds drilling with the boys, yeah.
I done came up, busting down a whole broke, broke, step back. Want your people swag, ain't even gotta ask. What are those, what is that? Please don't touch my rap. Please don't touch my rap. I'm racked up like rappers, I'm wrapped up on camera. Get out on camera, squeeze like asthma. It's rare wrath when I wear wrath, bare wrath when I wear wrath. Might invest into some rap shit, look. Still shit rap, and I'm dripping on rags. Rick gonna be the tag, do the digital dash. Yeah, I'm boasting, never brag. Please don't touch my rap. Or the Chris Van Nash, Alessandra Gucci glasses, the W Anderson collab. Yeah, pop it like yeah, you drop it on the. I'ma buy another. Cause the boys bring it back. Yeah, you know how to make it last. Plus, and keeping tabs. I'ma fly first class. Quavo hit him with the. Please don't touch my rap.
Don't step on my Ralph Simmons. Don't step on my Ralph Simmons. Don't step on my Ralph Simmons. Do you know how much I'm spending? My closet, it worth about a million. To the little out the runway. Then the kitchen. Ralph Simmons. All kind of crazy colors. Living color. Left wrist, roll it, ice. Made some Margiela my sweater. Margiela. Mama told me never settle. Ralph Simmons, don't lace them. Got your bitch, wanna.
Huh? What? Don't wanna talk about the papers. I swear to God, these be haters. They be hating, I feel out of the. Living cul-de-sac, don't get along. Move, right with my neighbors. Diamonds on my neck and rolling on. Now I later got
on different flavors. Done with my lightsaber. Ooh, feel like Darth Vader. I'm a boss, you know I might riff it. Ooh, right from my basement. Yeah. But you know that I'm gon' face it. Wait, that's the reason that they mad. Kalo Uzi, yeah, he made it. Yeah, I would have rap for I made it. Yeah, I would have rap for I made it. Yeah, got that rap all in my basement. Yeah, yeah, once I got patience. Yeah, I'm famous. Yeah, put my side aside, Mark Jacob. Hey, making them plays with my label. I get it, I count it. 100 on my table.
Turn the silver laser. That's rubies red, my skin too black to blush, too red to tint. Not pages. The saint on the green on the wizard up. Pocket pockets full of mint leaves. It's smelling like it brushed tea. Say cheese, see the porcelain. The water see deep. Backwoods. Wrath dragon on the floor. In it. I'm torching the road in these Gucci flames. Stuck to the pavement, they glued. I'm 2.5 million in the venue and 2,500 a tube. I'm cold like I'm sick with the flu. I cover my face and I'm that's spring summer 2002.
Yeah, please don't touch my ride. In the grass, Teddy, with the Teddy. Quick with the hands, ready. Please don't touch my please don't touch my ride. Shirt off, I'm Cam, ready. Dead stock in memory. Please don't pop my tie.
stack this paper and be alright. We gon' run it, keep gon' run it, keep on getting so on sight. Stick to the code, you get yours, I get mine.
Always hating, said I'll never make it. I heard these always talking with them. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay.
Trying to lie me, but I ain't no dummy. It's okay, though, gotta, you really want it. I spent 13 on the ring, and now I feel unlucky. If she love my diamond ring, she said she wanna touch it. It's okay, I get 30K just to hit the stage. Sip, hit my Michael, and my Michael J's. I get cake, I cannot complain. Been finessing since I was a kid in the second grade, selling limit.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a good one on tap today, and there's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron. It's Keenum's Vikings going up against Ryan's Falcons.
All right, Larry, thank you very much. We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League presented by EA Sports. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Minnesota Vikings. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll wind up getting an extra. Here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. is Murray. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Kyle Rudolph, the tight end, in motion. That was 2nd down run for Murray. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down.
Every year I go to the combine, I marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through.
On 3rd down, Bridgewater. Trying for right, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
After the interception, here's Ryan. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, 2nd down. Gabriel, the man in motion. They'll try and run for the first time with Freeman. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. A big hitter there. A 1st down gain of 26 yards.
We can talk about bend but don't break all we want. But the defense now, we're going to find out just how flexible and pliable they really are. Can they bounce back after that type of a run, that type of momentum against them, and find a way to slow down this offense?
They'll run here with Freeman. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead. Here's Botcher to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. Let's see how they attack him here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Now he'll go deep down the middle. And the defense loses him. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. First down, Bridgewater. That's caught inside the 20. A gain of 32 that time.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
From the red zone now, Bridgewater. Escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Deion Jones able to drop him for a loss of 4. Sack. Bridgewater now on second down. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And a short return will be stopped inside the 10 at the 8-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They go play action here on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And he gets it up to the 10-yard line here. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
On second down, Freeman. And some room for him there as he'll take this up to about the 15. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a third and about 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman. Yeah, brought down, but not before he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. They'll run it now out of the gun. Runs through the contact. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. Flush to his right. He's got his man on the crossing route. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. After the penalty, here's Freeman. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. That'll go as a loss of 5. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. With Ryan. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
How about this offense? Already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive. They've certainly come out firing even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield?
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and press your advantage.
And he motions the wide receiver. Here we go on fourth down with Ryan. And he can't escape the pressure. Ryan goes down. What a real head scratcher there. And the Vikings, they have the football now in excellent field position. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. On first down, Murray. Latavius Murray. Touchdown, Vikings! Latavius Murray, 40 yards! And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. and they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And here now come the Falcons. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense. Defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Freeman again, a first down carry. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
They run. Devontae Freeman. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here, because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. That burst good for 20 and a first down. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Coleman. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives them a first and goal.
That's how you get right up off of the mat, because on the last play, they stoned him in the backfield and dropped him for a loss. But he's the type of guy that scared me a little bit, because he's not daunted. Just got right back up, showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next run.
He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run, and just lost track, and it cost him.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Tevin Coleman, a 12-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Here's Bosher to kick it away. And the Vikings now heading on to the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Just keeping the play alive. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. And he's brought down after a good gain. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Bridgewater now from the 50. And Diggs has it. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
His throw caught at about the 5. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. 3 plays, 3 pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hitting this game, didn't it? For them to get downfield that quickly. And now first and goal, expect them to attack right here.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Bridgewater to throw it. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodge 2 pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think it hit.
And he'll get in. Touchdown, Minnesota. Latavius Murray, as the first half is winding down, and the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This will be taken very short. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
They go play action now. Ryan. Buying time to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. And that is incomplete. Okay, let's not waste any more time or certainly any more of Larry's time. Let's play ball. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. He gets them a little over half of what they needed. Now they're looking at a 3rd and 5. They run the play fake to Coleman. Now Ryan. And that is incomplete.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but
For the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
They'll indeed go for it with Ryan. He finds Coleman. 15 yards on the pickup there, and that leads to an Atlanta first down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Oh, fighting off the defender. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set him back for second down.
Well, add that play to his resume, Real, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big-time penetration, and throw people for losses.
They will run again with Coleman. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game, and while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
It's Coleman. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. That one good for 12 yards. And that's going to make it fourth down. No move to get the offense off the field here. They've converted once on this drive. On fourth, they'll go again and try it once more. They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. Looking deep for Gabriel. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Falcons. Taylor Gabriel, 47 yards. And the Falcons have broken our tie. Talk about a big fourth down conversion for the score defensively. How do you let that happen?
I think you start with the offense, and you give them credit for going for it, having that kind of, well, let's face it, audacity. But defensively, I think you're right on target, partner. There's no way something like that's supposed to happen in that situation. You're supposed to be able to shut that down and get the ball back for your own team. Instead, they give up not just a big play, but a touchdown.
Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. 23 yards on the play. Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. Throw left side on target to Thielen. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Second down, Bridgewater. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was looking for Jarius Wright that time. And it's third and short.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
They'll run here. It's Murray. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. From the gun, Bridgewater. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Keanu Neal. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And what a return as he brings this all the way back down to the 20-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Stepping up, he'll try and run. Give him three on the keeper there, and it is second down.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a third and seven. Play clock winding down. On third down, it's Coleman, and he'll take this one down near the 15. Just a gain of two there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Back now in Atlanta. It's the Falcons. They've got the football. They've got the lead as we get set to start the fourth. It's blocked. Now it's scoop. And now look at him go. He's at the 50. 30. Past the 20. And the Vikings are in for the touchdown. And now a critical extra point attempt here. And an important one that is, as we are tied now early in this fourth quarter. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They'll run with Freeman here to begin the drive. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Time running out here on the play clock. Again, they'll run with Freeman. Get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. He's been decisive. And he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. Now the pitch to Freeman. Freeman with a fast feed. There he goes inside the 30. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman, his second touchdown of the night. And the Falcons have broken our tie.
Hey, that score deserves our respect, deserves our excitement. But I'm looking at the clock and I'm thinking, there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit more time off. Now on the other sideline, you start to get the crew together and say, this is what we practiced a two-minute drill for, right?
Yeah, you hope you've been in that situation before, and if you haven't, you just have the confidence. Hey, let's go down there and get this thing done. But boy, that's a big score right there to give them the advantage.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
He's back to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. And on second and 10 now. It's incomplete. So it can't hang on. And as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit. Might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
The Vikings on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10. Back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And that gives him now 3 interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get 3 in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against with the Eagles, and I believe it was against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. And a great spot to start this drive from here. Tonight, Freeman. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Offense still needing 10 yards, second down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Ryan on the handoff. It's Freeman. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Another timeout called by the Vikings now. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. The Falcons on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. Here's Here's Coleman on the toss. Room here to run. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the...
But I still long. Got 100 different in my cell phone. Still 33, 4 long. Ride to my dog sitting in jail. Is that lighter on the grass, spin it back, roll. I'm on Keller, I'm on Special, I'm on Flat Show. I'm at Magic, I'm at Polish, let them go. Then it's right back to the when I'm low. Bars never close and we wide open. Kicking flavor with me, neighbor, yeah, we local. Rap the bottom, cause the bottom where we come from. Me no pray for little paper, need a love song. Real spiel, yeah, I would rather be a broke, real feel, little rich, fall in love with her. She just wanna be a VIP with her. Don't blame me, oh, they just shame me. Had to get it, how I got it on my phone to be. Don't blame me, I'm what the game made me, not what the fame made me. I won't let it change me, I'm the same.
On my block, yeah. On my, I won't stop, yeah. Play with me, I'll let it, yeah. Halo on me, say LeBron, yeah. Got me with a scooter. Get one, move, yeah. You my little baby boo, yeah. I love you like my favorite color.
Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down. Seem like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show them how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show them how to act. Okay, now picture little Bobby, just a younger, run around with his mans in his hand, feeling like a man. Run, put a, put it to your brain like. Everybody know you ain't about it. Everything you talk about. I know I can live without it. Red light, stop, green light, go. Everything ain't what it seemed like.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Two teams will need their quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today. It's Ryan's Falcons going up against Ryan's Falcons.
Thank you very much, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL, the National Football League, is here and on the air. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Atlanta Falcons. Here's Bosher to kick it away. First carry from the tailback, Devontae Freeman. And oh, right away, he lost the football.
To put it mildly, that is not the way anyone wants to start off a game. You fumble on your first offensive snap. But now what you're worried about is, does that linger throughout the game for your guys on offense? And how's the defense going to handle it? Because no one expects to run out on the field on the first play and have to all of a sudden start to play themselves.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position. Ryan leads with Freeman on the draw. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And a nice carry there of 15 yards. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because...
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Tevin Coleman, 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. Not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Second and just one. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here's Ryan, escaping the pressure right. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
So the sack pushes him back, and now third and long for Ryan and the Falcons. So the D-line's going to spread out. On third down, that's Coleman. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down.
I like like what they were thinking on defense, just guard the first down sticks. Don't let anyone pass that. Didn't matter whether they threw it or ran it. They just ended up rallying to the football on the running play and stopped them short of a first down.
And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. So out come the Falcons now. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
Shift together here from the D-line. Gabriel, the man in motion. On first and 10, it's Ryan. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Brooks Reed. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Here's Ryan to throw. And his throw here is incomplete. He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time. And now it's 3rd down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
Gabriel, the man in motion. Ryan. It's caught. Jones. A pickup of 24 on the 3rd down conversion. And that's the connection, Ryan to Jones, that this defense obviously has to key in on.
Certainly feels like they got the party started with that one, doesn't it? And when those two get in sync, it just scares the heck out of defenses because he can hit Julio Jones in a short zone, and he can take it the whole way.
On first down, Ryan. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
Going underneath, it's Coleman. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, big hit. Give him 9 on the play. And that is going to set up a 3rd and 1. Gabriel, the man in motion. Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. And a nice gain of 21 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on 3rd down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up the 1st down.
Flushed out right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Deion Jones. In there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. Gabriel, the man in motion. Now it's Ryan. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a 3rd down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
And it's caught. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the 1st down as he's tackled at the 1. Julio Jones, the lone receiver left. The toss play left. There goes Devontae Freeman. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll, in fact, tackle him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll make it 2nd and goal. They'll look to run with Freeman. And I don't think he got there. No, they stop him right where it all started. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a 3rd and goal. And this offense on 3rd down today, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak up. And he's got his his star receiver. It's Jones for the Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Here's Bosher to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 35, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down to the hands of the wrong team.
The Falcons averaged 34 points a game last year, tops in the NFL with that powerful offense, and they're already looking for more here as they've got it first and 10. After the interception, here's Ryan. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Julio Jones is off to a monster first half, but still, can he reach what he did against the Panthers in 2016? Didn't he go for a cool 300 in that game?
On the dot in week 4, 300 yards. Oh, Matt Ryan had a pretty good game, too, threw for over 500. And only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Now it's Ryan. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
The way he's been slinging in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown, but I guess he's got to wait to try to pick up that third, isn't it?
Yeah, I thought he had him for a second, but you're right, not to be. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's 4th.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And the 42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good. And the lead will grow. It's now 17-0.
It's good to be the kicker for the top offense in the NFL, and Matt Bryant was that in 2016, led the league in scoring with 158 points. But boy, does Atlanta find him valuable. So dependable and clutch.
And he's been valuable in this league for a while. Hard to believe he's been around since 2002. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. The play clock's running down. Now Ryan going to give it to Freeman. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Defenses always talk about earning the right to rush the passer on third down. And you know what offenses want? Win first down so that can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on first down. Freeman. Now it's Ryan. Now he's forced out right. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, the defensive guys won't be real happy. Maybe a sack on this play because he did get back to the line of scrimmage. But what a job they did overall. Hemmed him in and gave him nowhere to go with the football.
Ryan looking for Jones and it's intercepted. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks him and he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line.
When a team's turned it over three times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. Two interceptions, one caused fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. And a great spot to start this drive from here. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
It's Freeman. Big hold to the 30. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. Maybe a little sign of life here offensively, Charles. They get their first down. They didn't have any in quarter number one.
And I think what we're seeing is great evidence of good scouting by both teams, right? Understanding what they like to do, their best plays, try and take those away early. So now we're seeing some adjustments, and they end up getting their first down.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. On second down, Ryan. And for the third time here this half, it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation. But sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he's brought down. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. To play here in the first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. Gabriel, the man in motion. Now Ryan. Now he'll escape to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side into a double team, and it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick. Oh, and now he bowls him over, and he'll go down inside the 15 at his own 13-yard line. Not the best of plays there as a quarterback. You're right-handed, rolling left, trying to throw it that far downfield.
I remember a coach of mine saying, son, that's the equivalent of trying to get the car keys out of your pocket with your opposite hand while you're trying to run. You just can't do it.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And he goes across the 20 to the 22. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry.
I'd say it's pretty good strategy. If you throw interceptions on back-to-back drives, we'll see if the running backs can handle the ball a little bit, get things going. And also, You motivate your offensive line. I think they're in the mood to fire out and hit someone.
I thought the defense, though, might be a little more prepared for that run. Pretty good gain on the ground.
They go play action here on first down. He'll rifle this one deep right side. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones, 68 yards. And the Falcons get a bit closer.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-grab?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
How about the throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
Here's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And two interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw two interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas?
And no, not quite of that level and not of that age. But I remember looking over at him, and he was smiling. And I thought, what is he smiling about?
Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. He's at the 30, 10, 5. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae Freeman, 75 yards. And the Falcons will extend their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Here's Bosher to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Now a hit and a loose football. And the Falcons grab it. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line.
As that ball got away from him and he saw the opposing team recover it.
You felt his pain?
Oh, I felt his pain. And you know what was going through his head. Tuck it away. Take care of the ball. All the things he hears all week in practice, he didn't carry it over into the game.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position. Gabriel, the man in motion. To throw is Ryan. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. Ryan. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Here's Bryant for the extra point. And the lead is now 24. Here's Bosher to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And now running right through it. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Broke a tackle, but not much room there ultimately. Just up past the 25 and no further. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception.
It's Desmond Trufant.